So a client of ours has just asked, how do I terminate an employee and pay out all their annual leave? There are a few ways to do it, but I'm going to show you the correct way. So what you want to do is go to payroll, employees, so we first need to select the employee and set the date of termination. So once in their file, you want to go to the employment tab. And then up in the top right here, options and set termination date. Now we will set Odette's termination date to last Friday. Normally, we'll set that as the last day that they've worked or the day after. Okay, so we can see she's now terminated with the termination date in there. So that's all you need to do. One thing that you do need to check that if you're paying out annual leave, the annual leave does need to be set to paid out. So to do that, I just went to their leave tab and then clicked on the amount of hours they had owing. And then at the bottom here, it should say on termination, unused balance is paid out. Sometimes not paid out can be selected by accident, but in Australia, annual leave is always paid out. Sick leave and personal leave is not paid out. So, yeah, just ensure annual leave is paid out. And if you have sick or personal carers leave as well in here, that is not paid out. So, once we've done all that and checked that, we need to go back to the pay run. So, we'll go to payroll, pay employees, add pay run. And we know if you've got multiple calendars, we could see before that Odette was on the weekly calendar. So we want to select that pay period, week ending the 21st of March. And you can see there's two people on here. Now we just want to go into Odette's file. And you can see here, it's just a normal pay run, pay week for Odette, 35 hours. At this stage, you can see her annual leave has not been added here and it has not been paid out. So what we want to do is go right down to the bottom and set this as final pay. Now you'll get a box that pops up here. You can select the final pay type, normal termination or genuine redundancy, and select the pay period. Or you can enter manually if they've had a shorter week. You can change that, but otherwise, just normal pay period and select save. And you can see here that it's added on that annual leave as the final pay. Right now, I don't know if you picked up on it, but you can see here that this annual leave is actually slightly more than what we saw in her employee file. That's because she's obviously earned annual leave on this 35 hours this week, which also needs to be paid out. So then you would just process your pay run as per usual. And yep, that's all you need to know.